Ark Royal is 21,000 tons of floating runway. And though by this deployment she's 25 years old, it's only 3 years since her last major refit. So as she sails off to head up a big task force called Auriga, it seems inconceivable that in a few months' time, she'll be steaming to retirement. But there'll be many surprises on the way. This will prove an eventful mission. First, though, she needs planes. Just as Noah's Ark was built to carry animals, Ark Royal's an empty vessel, unless she's bustling with aircraft. And now she's 16 kilometers out to sea, they start swarming in. Starting with three types of helicopter. The Lynx. It can reach speeds of over 300 kilometers an hour, making it one of the fastest helicopters in the world. Equipped with up to four lightweight sea skewer missiles that proved themselves in the Falklands and the First Gulf War, or it can carry Stingray anti-submarine torpedoes. Then, the Sea King Mark VII, airborne surveillance and control. It allows the ship to see over the horizon with its early warning search water radar, located in the dome on the side. The dome rotates through 90 degrees to allow the Sea King to land. And the Merlin. Designed to operate day and night in all weathers, it's a sophisticated new helicopter with a composite fuselage and three computer-controlled engines capable of more than 300 kilometers an hour. At 14 tons, it can carry a range of weapons including Stingray homing torpedoes or depth charges. Next to arrive, the Harriers of the Naval Strike Wing. In the Strategic Defense and Security Review last year, Britain's entire carrier strike capability was decommissioned. So this is the last time the full squadron will use Ark Royal's flight deck. The Harrier was the world's first fixed-wing strike aircraft capable of vertical takeoff and landing. As the jump jet pulls alongside Ark Royal, it's running at full throttle, producing 22,000 pounds of thrust, enough to lift 10 cars off the ground. Almost its entire engine thrust is diverted downwards through its four main nozzles. In forward flight, the jet's ailerons, rudder, and elevators are used to steer. But when the plane stops and hovers, there's no airflow. So instead, some of the engine's thrust is diverted to mini jet nozzles in the wingtips, tail, and nose. By opening and closing these mini jets, the Harrier's flown rather like a spacecraft.